Due to all the recent leaks and videos that I'm about to show you in this video, it's very clear that Apple is about to make a massive push into the gaming space, which will begin with a brand new Apple TV that'll be focused on gaming, just like I was telling you guys in the video I made back in July. So in this video, I'm gonna cover all of the leaks and rumors surrounding this huge push into gaming. I'm gonna explain how it's gonna work, and then I'm gonna compare the potential performance of this Apple TV to Sony's PS5 and Microsoft's Xbox Series X to see if Apple can actually compete in the gaming space. But before I get into the PS5 and the Xbox comparison, I wanna take some time to show you guys some of the Apple TV 6 leaks and how I was able to estimate the performance of the A14X chip. The leaks started all the way back in March, with leaks ranging from Apple creating their own gaming controller to Apple creating a new Apple TV 6 with more storage than before, and even some leaks back in May saying that Apple already has a new TV ready to ship, while other more recent leaks say that it might be delayed until 2021. But the juiciest of leaks came just a couple of days ago from Fudge on Twitter, a new leaker with a 90.9% accuracy rating, according to the Apple rumor tracking website, which I discovered thanks to Renee Ritchie. On October 1st, just 6 days ago, Fudge mentioned that some time ago, Apple sent out an Apple TV to game developers with a new chip simulating the performance of the upcoming A14X chip. This probably means that Apple is preparing to launch some new game titles that require much more power, alongside the release of the upcoming Apple TV itself. And then 2 days later, Fudge said that Apple Arcade is getting big money poured into it, with games in the works that are aiming to rival the likes of Zelda Breath of the Wild, which is why the new Apple TV and controller are in the works. Someone later asked Fudge for clarification on the controller, and he said it's specifically meant for gaming. So it's gonna be an Apple-branded game controller similar to what you'd get with a PS5 or with an Xbox. Now, I personally believe that this new game controller is gonna work on every other Apple device, including the iPhone, the iPad, and even the future Apple Silicon Macs, so that's gonna be great. Within that same tweet, Fudge also mentioned that some games will require the A13 chip and up to run. Now, if you've been following my Apple Silicon videos, you'll know that Apple has added a new feature for developers, allowing them to make games that require a high-performance chip to run, like the A13. And like I said in my previous Apple gaming video, this points to high-end AAA games, like really high-end, because the new 2020 iPad with the A12 chip is able to easily handle games like Call of Duty Mobile and PUBG, and that's a completely fanless budget iPad for $329. So imagine games that are so demanding that they require at least the A13 chip. Yes, that means AAA games. Fudge even clarified his statement, saying that Apple wants their own larger scale titles with advanced graphics and more immersive stories. Basically, AAA titles. Now, if you know anything about AAA games, you'll know that many times they can take years to develop. And Apple only announced Apple Arcade on March 25th of 2019, about a year and a half ago. And a month after that, it was reported that Apple is spending a massive $500 million to fund the development of games for Apple Arcade. So there's a very good chance that apart from all the simple titles already available, there are already some massive AAA titles that have been in development for a year and a half, and Apple could be waiting to launch those larger games when they release the new Apple TV. That's what Apple needs to do if they truly want people to buy the Apple TV as a gaming console, because it's the games that matter. And that's the biggest advantage for the PS5 and the Xbox Series X, which have a long legacy of popular game support. Now, before I tell you guys the absolute most important feature that Apple is adding to make gaming on the Apple TV so enticing, I want to switch over to comparing the graphics performance capabilities of each of those consoles. The Sony PS5 has around 10.28 teraflops of power, and the Xbox Series X has a bit more, with around 12 teraflops of power. Now, the biggest question is just how much performance the new A14X chip will have, And the good news is that the performance of Apple's upcoming A14 chip going into the iPad Air 4 has already been leaked. That chip scored around 12,571 points in Geekbench 5's metal test, which is very impressive. Now looking into the past, going from the A10 chip to the A10X doubled the graphics performance. And going from the A12 to the A12X doubled the performance again. So if we assume that we'll see the same performance jump this year, the graphics performance of the A14X should be around 25,000 points in Geekbench 5. That's actually slightly more than AMD's 5300M graphics built into the 16-inch MacBook Pro. And keep in mind that the A14X is going into a very thin iPad Pro with no active cooling system, or into the new Apple TV with active cooling. And according to Tech PowerUp, the 5300M graphics chip has 3.2 teraflops of performance. So if we compare that to the PS5 and the Xbox Series X, the Apple TV with the A14X chip will still be way behind in terms of raw graphics performance. But the main question we need to answer is this: is 3.2 teraflops of performance enough? The main thing you need to realize is that games that are currently on iOS or on Apple Arcade are incredibly efficient and optimized. Like I mentioned before, the A12 chip in the iPad with only around 5,000 graphics score in Geekbench 5 runs Call of Duty Mobile perfectly well. And back when we still had Fortnite, the 2018 iPad Pro ran it at 120 FPS with no dropped frames at all. It was incredibly optimized. Sure, the graphics don't quite match up to the current level graphics that you have on consoles, but you still get the same great gaming experience, and that's what matters. Just look at Zelda Breath of the Wild. It doesn't have super good graphics, but it's still very popular. It's fairly simple and easy to run, being supported by low-level consoles like the Nintendo Switch. So Apple doesn't really need to match the raw performance of the PS5 or the Series X. The reason those other consoles need that much performance is because those games basically run on the old and clunky x86 architecture, which has a ton of overhead. So there's a good chance that the same game will run just as good on the Apple TV with only 3.2 teraflops of performance due to Apple's huge focus on efficiency and optimization with ARM compared to x86. Now you're probably thinking, why in the world would anyone buy an Apple TV and pay for Apple Arcade instead of just buying one of those other consoles? So let's get right into the main benefits. First off, the Apple TV is going to be quite a bit cheaper. It's currently priced at a maximum of $200, so the future A14X model probably won't cost any more than $250 compared to $400 for the PS5 and $500 for the Xbox Series X. Now there's also the Xbox Series S, and for $300, that's actually a killer deal. So it's clear that the folks over at Apple have a lot of work cut out for them, especially since they're starting fresh with brand new game titles, unlike Sony and Microsoft. But let's finally finish off with the most important feature that Apple is going to be pushing: online multiplayer crossplay and handoff between all Apple devices, including the Mac. The absolute most important feature of the Apple Silicon Macs is that for the first time ever, the code base will be shared between the iPhone, the iPad, the Apple TV, and the Mac. So developers only have to write the main code one time to reach every Apple device. So basically, you'll be able to play a game on the big screen using your Apple TV, and when you're finished, your progress is auto-saved, so you can jump on your couch and play it on your iPad, or jump in front of your computer desk and play it on your iMac or your MacBook. And then when you're on the go, you can play the same game on your iPhone. And with online crossplay, everyone with an Apple device can be matched up together. And thanks to Apple Arcade being only $5 a month, it's actually a great deal, beating out the price of the Xbox Game Pass. However, the reality is that great games take a long time to develop, so it's gonna take some time until Apple Arcade becomes very enticing. But keep in mind that AAA titles are gonna start coming to the iOS App Store and the Mac very soon, especially after people see the impressive performance of the new Apple Silicon chips. So thank you guys for watching, and hopefully you guys enjoyed my take on gaming coming to Apple devices. And if you completely disagree with what I said in this video, go ahead and voice your opinion in the comment section below, and be sure to check out some Apple Silicon videos right over there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.